All right. So today we have Bharati on this call with us. I have known her from the past almost a year, about 10, 11 months. And since I knew her, I always saw a very sincere human being who always wanted to grow and improve her confidence. She wanted to improve her entire life. And more than anything else, she is somebody who's a constant learner. She has a lot of experience, about more than, you know, close to 10 years of experience, more than 9 years. She works in the pharmaceutical industry. But one thing I always saw in her when I first spoke to her is that she had a hunger to improve. So Bharati, welcome to the call. Why don't you share quickly about a little bit about yourself, what do you do, and about your family, so people who watch you, who are watching you right now, can know who you are and what you do.
Yeah, Mr. Bishal, thank you. Thank you for the introduction. And I'm Bharati. I work for a pharmaceutical industry called Strides Pharmaceuticals Limited from around 10 years. Initially, before joining into your program, I had few challenges with respect to my confidence levels. So that is how I have approached you. And I am married and I have one daughter who is right now studying first standard. And growing up, I did not have, as you say in many of your videos, I did not have much confidence. And I think I can notice the difference in my confidence levels, which I had before I have attended to your program and now.
Yeah. Why don't you share about, I think you reached out to us last year, June or July.
Yes.
And you came to the September program 2017.
Yes, yes.
So before coming, what were the initial major one or two major problems you were facing in communication or public speaking, specific problems that made you reach out to us?
Yeah, the main specific reason that I have reached out you is because I was mainly facing the challenges with respect to my confidence. Even though I know the subject which I wanted to speak, I was not able to present in front of the seniors or in front of the group. That was the main thing. And there was a performance appraisal discussion that happened between me and my boss in 2017 May, through which it was an eye opener. The discussion was an eye opener because my boss told, I'm happy with your performance, but I want you to be more confident for you to promote to the next level. Otherwise, I don't have any issues with you. So that is the reason that is stopping me to promote you. So then I thought, even though I could go and argue with him or fight with him for my promotion, because I have done enough work to get that, I just wanted to improve myself and make myself deserving for the promotion, not begging in front of him for the promotion. So that is what I wanted to do. So then I started, the immediate day I started searching for, is there anyone like me? So I felt like I'm the only guy, or I'm the only person who is like this. So once I started, I think you are the ones which most appears on the Google page or YouTube. So through that, I came to know that there are people like me. So that is the first small happiness for me. And I have approached. And then I got, you have interviewed me and I got selected. I thought that was the first achievement for me. And then I came to the program, which happened for around 3 days. And through the program, when I attended the program, the learnings that I had made me feel that there is something beyond the confidence that I can learn and I can improve myself. I came with a lot of hunger, but actually instead of satisfying my hunger levels have increased after attending the program. So it made me feel that there is something beyond.
Absolutely. You know, you remind me of this when you just said it right now, that my hunger increased. I remember there was a time I had a mentor called Oliver from USA, and I reached out to him and I told him my goals and stuff. And he said that, and especially about finances, he told me this specific line and that I remember very well. Back then, one of my goals was to, I forgot, like something like 3 to 5 lakhs rupees a month was my goal at that time to achieve, many years ago. And he said, okay, Bishal, I want you to make a goal 10 times more. I want you to tell me how you're going to spend that money every month. Because at that time, I did not know how to spend 30 lakhs right? It was like beyond my imagination. He said, no, before we speak next, now my hunger increased. See, that's not greed. That's like drive for me. Now I needed a plan that, oh, I can take more money and maybe, you know, grow my team, or I can take more money and give it away and help those nonprofit organization, or I could go and help more people, or I could just develop myself more, or I could help more people so that I have more time freedom for me and my brother. And so that was like, my hunger increased more because now I had a bigger goal. And that always changed for me. So you remind me of that. And I remember the time when you first came, it was all about, I just want to improve my confidence. I said, it's going to happen. And it did. And then you realize that, you know, I want to be a better leader. You told me on the phone call after the program, when I spoke to you about when you applied for the mastermind, what we now call the Balanced Life Mastermind, you said, I want to have more time freedom for myself. I want to improve my income and I want to improve my leadership. And I want to make sure that I become much more visible in my organization. So after the improvement in your confidence, you know, overcome your stage fear, tell me specifically what propelled you or what made you increase your hunger, and why did you want to join the mastermind? What was your initial like hard motivation factor?
Most of the times I thought before attending the program that it is only the confidence that I have to improve. So I came with the same mindset into the program. So, but as the program proceeded for the 3 days, there were many learnings that apart from the confidence, there is much more beyond in the life to learn and to improve ourselves. It is always important to keep ourselves updated so that we are not outdated anywhere we go. So yeah, that made me feel that there is something beyond the confidence, which was my initial requirement, that I have to improve upon and make myself a better version of mine, and also to keep myself updated, happy. I think we have that rule framework, yeah, which had mainly motivated me to enter into the mastermind, that there is something beyond what I required, so that I can improve myself, which is an eye-opener to me. I grow in my eyes rather than growing in anyone's eyes. That is what I felt.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's always about the improvement. Instead of comparing yourself to other people, you compare yourself to your own potential and what's possible for you. So, Bharati, how is your family life better off because of what you have been learning for the last 9 or 10 months?
Two things quickly I can share, even though there are many things, quickly I can share two things. The very first thing is enjoying the present moment. I was not like this before, always thinking that someday would be better than this day. This was what my mindset was. So now my mindset has completely changed. Now I always feel that this is a moment which you have to enjoy. As you say, there is no happy ending to an unhappy journey. That has got, I think it has got stick to my, it has very deeply penetrated into my mind and heart. So this is what strictly I follow. No, whatever I do, I enjoy the moment. So whether it is the family, now I'm concentrating more on my daughter also. Before, I was more into household activities or whatever, because I have to balance both work and family. I was more into. So now I'm prioritizing, like this is what my priority is. That is the second priority. I know my priorities now. I'm prioritizing and spending more time with my daughter. And the other great thing is, in the last mastermind, we have learned that love languages, 5 love languages, which I have implemented at home. As I have shared you in one call also, that I made my husband also realize what are my love languages forcefully, and now he knows that, and it is giving more cooperation from him with respect to the. I had a complaint previously that he is not cooperating with me in the household activities. So now he knows what I want. So rather than giving what he wants, he knows what I want, and that makes me more happy.
Do you think your husband and you are connecting more because of applying that love language?
Yes.
Just to make sure that if you're watching the video, just to make sure you understand what she's talking about. So there are 5 different love languages. We'll not talk about it here, but this is something that we teach under the rapid relationship, because you know, Bharati, I'm sure you know a lot of people like this who have a lot of great success in their career, but inside the home, it's all broken relationships they have. No matter how much money you have, if your family relationships are not at a great level, it's always going to bother you. Always going to bother you. So some people feel like, oh, I'm doing good. But the example I give is this. If my person, whoever I'm connecting with, it can be my son, my daughter, my wife, my mother, my father, my husband, whoever. That person likes chocolate flavor and I always bring mango flavor. Doesn't matter. Maybe the chocolate flavor they like costs me 100 rupees and I bring 1,000 rupees mango flavor, they're still not gonna like. I can tell them it's 1,000 rupees, it's 10,000, but they don't like mango. So many times I hear from people that, you know, I'm doing all the things for my family, but my wife is still not happy or my children are not still happy. Why? Because they're not connecting with that level of deep connection for the family. So I appreciate you saying that. Another thing that stood out to me, what you just now said, is that level of presence that you have. I just wrote down something right now. I think you'll agree with this, is that presence can't buy you presence. You know, you can buy a lot, you can buy great things, but that doesn't mean you have that presence of mind. So presence, gifts only can't give you that peace of mind. You can have a big, soft, expensive bed. That does not guarantee a peaceful sleep. I know a lot of people right now who are going through a lot of challenges in life, and no matter what happens, they don't have that peace of mind. They don't have, and I often ask people this question, Bharati, that are you really happy in life? And most times the answer is, well, nobody's really happy. I said, I'm not talking about everybody. I'm talking about you. Are you really happy? Yes or no? And most people say, they dodge the question. It's a simple question, but sometimes, most often, people are not happy. And I'm very happy. I'm grateful that you already were happy as a human being before we even met, but now we have taken to another level where you have control over that happiness versus giving that to somebody else's approval. If you like it, then I'll be happy. That's gone. Tell me this. I know a lot of people who improve something in life and then they settle, right? So it's kind of like this. They are going up and then they think, you know, I have improved a lot. I don't need to improve more. I'll just stay here. Instead of making that progress, they stay stuck here. You are not that. When you got to one level, you said, I don't want to just because I took a breath right now doesn't mean I'm not going to take a breath next moment. So what message do you have for those people who are settling for an average life? So if you are right now talking to them, imagine this, what message would you have for them, Bharati?
I strongly believe that if you're not updated, you're outdated. This happened with me and I was also the victim of this phrase 1 year back. So once we are updated, everything in our life changes. Everything surroundingly comes as an additive effect to that. The main effect which I feel strongly is our confidence levels will increase. We will be more happier. Anywhere we go, we will not feel that loneliness that we do. We are not the victims of this. Because somewhere you go, somebody shares some story, you will be always on the happier side. Instead of being on the suffering side, we will be always on the happier side. That's what the difference I felt once you start updating yourself with respect to anything in the life. Whether it is with respect to your subject matter or with respect to the life that that we are leading about, anything, it mainly makes that stay on the other side. Instead of being on the suffering side, we stay on the happier side.
Yeah. You know, you have met the people in the mastermind, great group. What do you think about not just the mastermind program, but what do you like about the group the most?
The greatest part is everybody enjoys and celebrates everybody's achievement. This is the greatest greatest thing that I can say in the mastermind. And it's like all the peers encourage each other to reach the heights, and something which I do will be an inspiration for the other person in the mastermind, and something which others do will be an inspiration for me. It is a mutual a team.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, it's very hard to find a group like this, right? I mean, people like this.
Very positive.
Yeah. I mean, most often when you share your success, I'm not talking specifically about you, but in general, when you share your success in the office, some people will be like, oh yeah, congratulations. But deep inside, you know, they're not very happy about your progress very often. They're like, they're saying, yeah, fine. But deep inside they feel, oh my God, you know, they have that level of jealousy sometimes. And because of which, you know, you don't feel like sharing your success the next time. And sometimes that can be counterintuitive. Sometimes this is like, oh my God, how do I improve more if all the time the people that I share with are not very, very happy? So what do you know, sometimes when you share, for example, there was a time I had some friends, Bharati, and I used to share with them about my success, and they used to tell me like, Bishal, you're already doing good, why do you want to be better? Like, instead of growing me and encouraging my growth, they always told me like, you don't need so much. So have you ever met people like this in your life, Bharati?
Yes, we do meet, definitely.
Absolutely. Here's the final question I have, final two questions. If this video is being watched by people who have never come to my program to improve public speaking, and also the people who are coming to improve public speaking, but they feel they know it all and they don't want to improve all different areas of their lives, just like you have improved in all different areas, what message would you have for them?
I have one simple message. I can say that before coming to the program, I was thinking it is a program that will improve my confidence. But it is like, now I'm feeling that this is one of the life skills that we have to learn. It is as important as any other skill, life skill that we term. It is not an advanced skill that has to be learned after going to certain level. It is a life skill. It is something very basic that everybody has to undergo in order to have a balanced life. And working professionals to be confident to present their ideas, which I am doing it right now, and I was not able to do it 1 year back.
Yeah.
This has become, this is a very basic thing. That's what I feel right now.
In fact, I remember just 2 weeks ago, we mapped out, I don't know where that is right now, but we mapped out your, was it 1 day or 2 day, training program that you're going to be doing for your company this week or this month?
Yeah, in this month.
This month, and we structured the entire 2 day. Was it a 2 day program or 1 day?
1 day program.
One day. So, you know, giving a 5 minute, 10 minute presentation is different than giving a like a one full day training. And you are doing it because last year you could not do this because you are not selected, but this year you are because of the visibility. And this is so amazing. We like, this is what we do in the mastermind. It's not just teaching a bunch of things. It's finding the proper balance and then upgrading all different areas of your life. So here is a question. Many people think, which is true, many of my programs are expensive money-wise. And I totally understand because I, in fact, say that it's not for everybody. However, Bharati, you don't come from a millionaire family. You were not born and brought up with a silver spoon, just like I was not born and brought up in a silver spoon. And in fact, enrolling in the mastermind after the initial program, the public speaking program, when you wanted to enroll in the mastermind, financially it was a stretch for you. But instead of making excuses, you arranged things and you still did it. So what message you have for people who want to go for the mastermind and they want to, first of all, it's not for everybody. Just because somebody has the money doesn't mean they can get selected for the mastermind. We have a private call with them to make sure they're a right fit. But if somebody is a right fit and it's still beyond their any affordability, what message you have for them about anything? How did you do this? Why did you stretch, and why should they?
The main reason that I have stretched is the strong intention of improving myself. That is the only one and one reason that I have invested. It is really, really a very big stretch for me. And After attending the program, as I said, I'm reinforcing again that there is much more beyond to learn, not only the public speaking or the tips that you need to present in front of the group. There is much more beyond to learn in the life. And I had a strong intention to improve on myself. So I have stretched, and I never regretted that I have invested so much.
Absolutely.
There is not even a single minute or a single day that I have regretted. No regrets at all.
Are you happy to be a part of this program, Bharati?
Surely. Very, very happy.
All right. Here is the final question for the day. How does Bharati, the lady, want to be remembered at the end of her life?
Bharati wants her to be remembered as somebody who has created a great impact. Mainly my target is, even though it's not a very short-term goal, a very long-term goal, maybe at the age of 60 or 65, I want to be remembered as somebody who has done something with respect to the education system in the country. This is what something which makes me bogged up. Like, I don't feel that the current education system in the country is teaching children the right skills that they want when they come out of the college or school. All the right skills are not being taught. So I want to change the education system such that all the skills, as I said, nobody teaches public speaking as a skill in the college or school. It is only the elocution that is totally different than what we learned now. It's not like internalizing, it's not never memorizing. But our school days always teaches us elocution as memorizing, never as internalizing.
Yeah.
Yes. So I think there are many such changes like life skills which have to be taught in the schools because they are our future. So I want to be remembered as somebody who has brought some changes in the positive changes in the education system of the country.
And one major appreciation I want to give you now that we want to end the call is this. You, for me as a human being, as a mentor, for me, you are an example, Bharati. And the reason I say that is, you know, I meet people all the time who talk about, I want to bring a change and all that. And I say, okay, are you changing? What have you changed in last 1 year to change yourself? You want to grow everybody? You want to grow India? What have you done to grow yourself in the last 1 year? And most people don't have an answer. Oh, I'm busy. I know they are talking about all this. They can't ever do all that. Not because they are bad people, because they are not being an example for themselves. So often I meet financial advisors whose finances are completely screwed up. So often I meet yoga teachers who are completely fat. So often I meet leaders, you know, leadership trainers who are very, very just aggressive, nothing else. And that's why I want to salute and respect you, Bharati, because you're not just talking about change. You have brought in the change in yourself. You had the lack of confidence, you improved that. You had the lack of many other different skill sets you have. And more than anything else, I have never seen you made excuses for yourself that, oh, this is not right or I'm not getting time. You always took the steps. You came to all the mastermind meetings. We're going to have another one next month. You came to all the mastermind calls. You took the steps and you were a massive note taker, by the way. You take like pages and pages of notes in your journal. And I remember, I think, I don't know if I can find it right now, but you sent me a journal and a card a few weeks back, not a few weeks, a few months back to my home. And that was really, really a nice gesture because not because of the gift, but because it really made me feel special about what you're doing. In fact, I just got it, my drawer. So this was the card that you sent me. It says, this is the card, and here was your notes there, what you wrote. Do I have your permission to read it out for everybody?
Yes, sure. No problem.
It says, I'm so grateful to you for all the change in my life. You're a real legendary example. Thank you so much. And in handwriting, you said, Mr. Bishal, thank you for being a role model, always pushing our boundaries and for walking the talk. My regards to you. My regards to your family and blessings to Bibek. By the way, Bibek is my brother, so thank you. Wishing you and your family all the good health, happiness, and prosperity. Thank you, Mr. Bishal, Bharati. P.S. You have removed fear out of me and made me in such a way that I couldn't believe my past. Now I love myself and confident that I could achieve anything if I aspired to. All my family is thankful to you. I really appreciate that. I really appreciate that. This is not just for me a card. This is something that I'm keeping in my drawer. You know, sometimes people send me cards, emails, phone calls, messages about the transformation they're receiving. It really means a lot to me. This was the journal that you sent me. Remember? So thank you so much for the gift. And more than the gift, the best gift you have given me personally is the person that you have become in your life. And watching your transformation is an honor. It's been an honor to mentor you and guide you in your life. And I so much respect and admire you and your entire family, Bharati.
This means a lot to me, Mr. Vishal. Thank you so much. This is still more inspiring for me.
You're very welcome. So that's all for this week. If you're watching this video, Bharati's story really inspired a lot of people in the events. And, you know, it's inspiring a lot of people who are watching this video right now. And I want to say the same thing to you. Bharati can come from lack of confidence and can become a confident speaker. And if she can take the fear out of herself, you can do the same thing. And not just in public speaking. See, once she improved her public speaking, she understood that there are other areas of her life, the relationship, the health, the impact, the social impact, the inner connection, removing the emotional blockages, having the mastery, having the financial freedom. And she's working on all of that at the simultaneous level at the same time, so she could have a balanced life. And I want the same thing for you. So if you want more information about how this can work out for you, reach out to one of our team members and we're going to have a conversation. Bharati, yes. Go ahead. You want to say something?
I just wanted to add on one point. 1 year back, this is June, right? In the May month, I was one of the member who was listening to what you're saying now, the video. I was watching all this, and there is a massive change in this 1 year span of time. I was remembering my days app, which I have attended the, I had discussion with my boss regarding the appraisal, and I was so frustrated and seeing all my, I was searching thoroughly, like I'll get some mentor to mentor me, to guide me. And I was watching all these success stories of somebody. So today I have become one success story. This is really, I'm feeling really, really that I have achieved something. Thank you so much, really.
You have. And you know what? I want to say the same thing to the people watching the video. The same thing can happen for you today at this moment right now. You're probably watching it on your phone or your laptop, and maybe one day I'm going to be interviewing you because of your transformation as a result of the programs that you have attended in the Mastermind, also in the Confident Man Conference. So have a great time. So this is Bishal Sarkar, always reminding you that confidence is not about perfection. It's all about connection.